First of all, what did you have to do to try to just hang on there amidst that big run? You know, you can't put Lonzo back in the game. What did it take?
Well, it was tough. I knew, you know, we shot an incredible percentage in the first half. I've been in a number of those games in my career where you have the big, gigantic lead, and the other team always makes a run. And I knew Dallas would come after us, and they did. Obviously, when you lose Lonzo, it's tough on the team. But, I really want to give a lot of credit to those guys that came in and held on. I mean, Gabe York hasn't played a whole lot for us. He came in and hit huge free throws down the stretch. I'm looking at the numbers here. All of our starters were in double figures. We had a ton of assists. We're starting to bond, and we're a team. And it's amazing because it's been seven games, but everyone's helping one another. Everyone's on the same page, and it's really fun right now.
Any indication yet about Lonzo? Just first of all, how the Cavs doing, and then if you'll be able to use him for tomorrow?
No idea yet. Obviously, he had some tightness. The medical staff pulled him out. He was out for the game. We'll see. He's going to get treatment tonight, treatment in the morning, and we'll find out probably tomorrow, after our breakfast meeting, if he'll be able to go or not.
So what is that balance between it? Yes, they're all young, but this is also it's unconventional, unusual to play so many games in a row. How do you kind of weigh that out as you look for tomorrow?
Yeah, it's tricky. I mean, he's had, he came into this tournament with that tightness, and obviously he's played a ton of minutes, especially with, has it been 4 and 5 nights, 5 and 6 nights or whatever? So, his health is number one. It's a tricky balance because I know he wants to play, he wants to be out there, but, he's a major asset for us. So we'll let the medical staff and management decide if he can play, and if he plays, how many minutes, we don't know. But I know he wants to be out there. What's that? Yeah. Well, it makes it a lot easier on the coaches when your guys can shoot like that. It was just ridiculous. I mean, it's so fun. These guys have put a lot of work in. But when you get it going like that, for a second there, I've had a slight feeling what Steve Kerr feels like when they make all those threes. So it was amazing, and I was happy for him.
What did you see happening in the fourth quarter that led Dallas back in the game?
Well, we lost a little momentum. Dallas is gritty and tough, and, they hadn't lost a game all summer. We knew they were going to come after us. We just kind of had to hang on. Too many turnovers for us, too many offensive rebounds for them. That combination kind of led to their comeback, and they just really forced it kind of down the gut on us. They weren't shooting a lot of some threes, but a lot of the points were just in the paint, easy layups. So, we knew they were going to come back at us, and they did.
How far did these guys have to dig deep, though, when you're looking at that scoreboard in the fourth, up 20, and the lead is down to one?
Stuff, yeah. It showed some character of the guys we have on the roster, and I contribute that to management and the guys that they brought in to be a part of this. I'm just so happy for them because I felt like we played hard enough to win that game. It's just the game of basketball is tricky. Those big leads, we had it happen to us, a couple nights ago when we lost a big lead. So that's just kind of the way things go. And again, I'm just really happy for those guys that were able to play some minutes and really close the game out.
What are you thinking as you're watching Lonzo in that first half, the three straight assists and then the step back three, and he just kind of had it all working?
Yeah, he was amazing. He was amazing. He's getting better and better. Obviously, more comfortable with what we're doing. Heedless was dynamite there for about, 12-minute stretch there in the first quarter and into the second quarter a little bit. Tried to get him out, but that group was just rolling, and so maybe I left him in a little too long. But you can see what he's all about, and he's a winner. That's what he is.
Last one. What's impressed you most about Kyle Kuzma's game so far?
He's had an incredible summer for us, summer league experience. Obviously, his shooting's been great, but just his overall athleticism. He's when people have closed out on him, he's been able to put the ball by them, finish at the basket. I think another thing that kind of goes unnoticed is that he can really run the court well. I mean, when you have a point guard like Lonzo, if you can just sprint down, rim run, we call it, you're going to get two or three layups a game. But he's had a great summer league, and I'm really happy for him.